Here we're going to look at a simplified model of predator-prey interactions. The idea being we have so many sheep, we have so many coyote, and of course the coyote eat the sheep. And so we can write down differential equations that model this interaction, where I've defined the terms sheep population, meaning the number of sheep, coyote population, number of coyotes, and then various constants. Now, of course, the results of the model depend very much on what these constants are. We're just picking values here to help us model the system, get an idea basically of a kinetic model, solving differential equations, initial value problems. And what we want to know is how the number sheep and coyote change as a function of time. And then suppose instead of 50 coyote, which what the case will solve initially, suppose we start with 20 coyote and the same number of sheep. How is the result different? So let's look at these differential equations first in a little more detail. So this term corresponds to how the number of sheep change with time. This corresponds to how the number of coyote change with time. This term says as we have more sheep, then the number of sheep, the rate that they increase will be higher. And this term says, because notice the negative sign, as we have more sheep, the number of sheep will start decreasing faster. And it also says, as we have more coyote, the number of sheep will decrease faster. Again, a simplified model. For coyote, this says, as the number of coyote increase, then the rate that they'll start decreasing is faster, dying off. This says, as we have more sheep, we have more coyote, we have more food for the coyote to eat. Like this term, but this proportionality factor, alpha, is much less than 1 to make a realistic model. So here's the model. We're just going to solve this initial value problem. We have initial conditions, we have values for the constant. If we do that, what I'm showing you is plots. On the left is the number, right? So this is sheep, and this is coyote. But notice I've multiplied the coyote by 100 so I can show them on the same plot. A couple things to notice. One, there's pretty large oscillations in the number of sheep and number of coyote as a function of time. And these oscillations are not in phase, meaning when I have a maximum in the sheep population, only at a later time do I have a maximum in the coyote population. Likewise, when I have a minimum, at a later time I have a minimum. An alternate way of plotting this is a phase plane, which is shown on the right. So what I'm plotting here on the y-axis, this is the number of sheep. And on the x-axis, it's the number of coyote, again, multiplied by 100. And so time proceeds this way. In other words, I've taken the data on the left and just picked a point and say, for this many coyote, I have this many sheep. Later time, a different number of coyote, different number of sheep. And so I just plot those continuously going around this phase plane. And this gives you an idea of how they are out of phase with each other. And also, you'll notice that in this region, the number of coyote increase, right? So the coyote are going up while the number of sheep are going down. And then I look at the region below it. Here, the number of coyote are going down, and the number of sheep are also going down. And then we have the alternating behavior as we go around this phase plane. So a phase plane is a good way to get a better idea of the behavior of the system. If we change the number of coyote initially, actually we see rather dramatic sensitivity to the number of coyotes. So now notice the changes, the oscillations have a different time scale. They also have much larger number of sheep. We're almost up to 10,000 sheep. And notice we get down very close to zero. The coyote eat almost all the sheep, and then the coyote population starts dying off, and the sheep recover. Now, in the phase plane plot, again, we're going around in this direction. So you can, again, see this behavior on the right. Coyote numbers are increasing while the sheep are decreasing, whereas on the left, coyote numbers are increasing while the sheep numbers are increasing. And so these phase plane plots give you a better visualization of the behavior. And you can see fairly complex behavior for a fairly simple model. Now, this model was obtained by solving just the differential equations. I happen to use polymath, which is a simple, easy to use, but quite sophisticated program. Here are the program statements, the differential equations, and the initial conditions and comments. And then just finish by pointing out this is a simplistic model. We could certainly add additional terms to account for the fact there are other food sources for a coyote, the fact that sheep can die by other means than just being eaten by coyotes. And there's nothing that says a reasonable model is the reproduction rate is linear in the number of sheep instead of, say, squared in the number of sheep. And then at some point, the food supply is going to make a difference for the sheep, that the sheep population gets too large. There's not enough food. Depends very much on the physical system. But we can add in these terms just the way we account in kinetics for various reactions to observe the behavior of the system as a function of time.